Determine if each sequence is arithmetic, geometric, or neither. For a quick review, a sequence is arithmetic if we have a common difference d equal to a sub n minus a sub n minus 1. Meaning if the sequence is arithmetic, we can determine the common difference d by taking any term in the sequence given by a sub n and subtracting the term before it given by a sub n minus 1. Also, if a sequence is arithmetic, a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 plus d, meaning we can find any term in the sequence given by a sub n by taking the previous term given by a sub n minus 1 and then adding the common difference. If we have a geometric sequence, then there's a common ratio equal to a sub n divided by a sub n minus 1. Again, this indicates we can find the common ratio r if we have a geometric sequence by taking any term in the sequence and dividing by the term before it. And for a geometric sequence, a sub n equals a sub n minus 1 times r, where if we have a geometric sequence, we can find any term in the sequence by taking the term before it and multiplying by r. Analyzing the first sequence, we should recognize a pattern of addition. Negative 16 plus 7 is negative 9. Negative 9 plus 7 is negative 2. Negative 2 plus 7 is 5. 5 plus 7 is 12. And 12 plus 7 is equal to 19. Because we found each term in the sequence by taking the previous term and adding the same constant 7, the common difference d is 7, and the sequence is arithmetic. If we had a hard time recognizing the pattern of addition, we can check for a common difference d several times using the sequence. For example, the common difference d must equal a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which would be negative 9 minus negative 16, which simplifies to plus 16. Negative 9 plus 16 is positive 7. The common difference d is also equal to a sub 3 minus a sub 2, which is negative 2 minus negative 9, which simplifies to negative 2 plus 9, or positive 7. Let's just check one more. The common difference d must also equal a sub 4 minus a sub 3, which is equal to 5 minus negative 2, which is also 7. So again, if we don't recognize the pattern of addition, we can always determine d and make sure we get the same value for d each time. And now looking at the next sequence, let's just say we don't recognize a pattern, then let's check for a common difference d using a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which would be negative 2 minus negative 64, which is equal to 62. But then if we check for the common difference d using a sub 3 minus a sub 2, we would have 0 minus negative 2, which equals positive 2, not 62. We don't have a common difference. The sequence is not arithmetic. Let's say we also didn't recognize a pattern of multiplication. Then we would check for a common ratio r. Using a sub 2 and a sub 1, the common ratio r must equal a sub 2 divided by a sub 1, which is negative 2, divided by negative 64, which is 1 divided by 32. And now check for a common ratio r using a sub 3 and a sub 2. The common ratio r would have to be equal to a sub 3 divided by a sub 2, which doesn't work because 0 divided by negative 2 is 0, not 1 divided by 32 or 1/32. There's also not a common ratio. The sequence is neither arithmetic or geometric. And now let's check the last sequence. If we check for a pattern of addition, notice 3 plus 6 is 9, but 9 plus 6 is not 27, and therefore the sequence is not arithmetic, and we don't have a common difference d. Or using the formulas, we'd have the common difference d equals, or using the formulas, the common difference d would have to be equal to a sub 2 minus a sub 1, which is 9 minus 3, which equals 6. But then using the common difference d and a sub 3 and a sub 2, we have a sub 3 minus a sub 2, which is 27 minus 9, which is not 6, it's actually 18. Again, verifying the sequence is not arithmetic. But if we look for a pattern of multiplication, notice 3 times 3 is 9, 9 times 3 is 27, 27 times 3 is 81. 81 times 3 is 243. Because we're multiplying each previous term by 3 to get the next term of the sequence, we have a geometric sequence where the common ratio r is 3. Or using our formulas to check r, using a sub 2 and a sub 1, we'd have r equals a sub 2 divided by a sub 1, which is 9 divided by 3, which of course is 3. Let's use a sub 3 and a sub 2. We'd have a sub 3 divided by a sub 2, which is 27 divided by 9, which is also 3. We could check several other quotients, but we will always have the same common ratio r equals 3. This indicates the last sequence is geometric. I hope you found this helpful.